This is the third video in the series on aerodynamics, brought to you by the Science of Flight, a new brand here on YouTube, a brand dedicated to aerospace engineering, education, and software. In this video, we're going to talk about different aerodynamic methods. So let's get to it. There are three general approaches at tackling an engineering problem: theoretical, experimental, and numerical. Now, these three approaches are also found in aerodynamics as well. A theoretical approach involves a mathematical analysis using known relationships. We call these relationships equations or laws, and we use these equations and known parameters to determine unknown parameters. Now, sometimes these are simple enough that you can do them by hand on a piece of paper. Sometimes they involve lots of calculations, lots of different equations, and sometimes even like a specific algorithm or a specific order that you're supposed to perform certain tasks. And usually that's where some of these different methods that you see, they're listed. That's how they differ. Maybe they use different equations, maybe they use different parameters, or maybe they use a different algorithm. But they're usually designed to figure out an unknown parameter based on known parameters and known relationships. Right? This is kind of the plug and chug approach. Now, each of those methods that I have listed, I'm planning on giving several videos dedicated to each method. You know, we can explore the method, we can run through several examples, develop software code for multiple platforms. So definitely stay tuned, there's lots of good videos to come. If there's another method you think that you'd like to hear about, go ahead and throw it in the comments below. I can definitely cover it. So yeah, definitely stay tuned. Another approach is the experimental approach. This is where you go out to the lab and perform tests to determine empirical approximations based on the data you collect. You know, so this would be the test for your answers approach. Now, from an aerospace point of view, this usually means building, which can take a while, and testing, which can take a while, a scaled model in a wind tunnel, or wiring up an aircraft with sensors to collect data during a specific test flight program. Now, the last approach is numerical methods. This approach uses computer simulation of mathematical models to arrive at the likely solution. This is the CFD, or if you're a structured person, this is kind of similar to an ANSYS approach, where you're doing a lot of number crunching in the computer with simulation to try and determine the likely solution. Now, while some engineers have their preferred method, the one they trust more, or the one they like doing the best approach actually uses multiple independent methods to build confidence in the solution. Confidence, of course, being increased with each independent method used to arrive at the solution, or that confirm solutions from other methods. Let's kind of go over, I guess, quickly go over what a typical aerodynamic design, maybe of like an aircraft or a drone or something like, might actually look like. Now, usually it doesn't have to be this way, but it's kind of like a good approach, a typical approach for this design. Now, a lot of times you might start out with a theoretical approach, which is kind of a quick way to get in the ballpark solutions, kind of a quick, rough estimate, order of magnitude type of approach to kind of get pretty close to the solution. Pretty quickly, not spending a whole lot of time or money on it. Now, depending, of course, on the results of that, Then the next step is usually building models and throwing them into a wind tunnel, or throwing them, or building models in the computer and running it through CFD to kind of get the more refined solution, the better results. But usually this takes more time, it usually takes more money. And so that's why it's usually not done first, because of the money and the time involved. But it's usually kind of in there somewhere. But then of course, based on your results from that test, from those tests, the CFD and the wind tunnel, obviously there might be several iterations depending on what you find out. You know, you might find out you have too much drag, and you've got to adjust the design. So you adjust the design and then you re-throw it into the wind tunnel or into the CFD and you retest it. So there might be some iterations in there, but that's usually kind of a step on the process. Now after you kind of get through that step and you've built up a lot of confidence in your results based on a lot of simulations or a lot of wind tunnel data, preferably both, then a lot of times you'll kind of go into the full scale prototype and test flight program stage. And this is where you'll put like a prototype through an actual flight test program, and you will sometimes have different goals of that test program. For instance, you might be trying to verify values you obtained in the wind tunnel or in the CFD. You might be trying to perform like a parameter identification, doing flight test, using flight test to kind of determine certain parameters. You know, the testing approach we talked about earlier, or you might be determining the handling qualities of the aircraft. You know, you could have several different goals and actually accomplish multiple goals in that flight test program. And of course, after it's meet satisfactory, after it's satisfactorily completed the kind of flight test program, then it would go into production and kind of go out the door to the customer. Now, as you can see, each approach kind of has its place and has its pros and its cons. And a great engineer will actually be well versed in all three approaches. So kind of the idea of this series is to be covering all three approaches with the different methods that each contains, so that you can kind of start developing a mastery over them. And as I said before, kind of stay tuned, there's lots of good stuff to come. All right, that's the end of the third video. If you like what you saw and you want to see more, like the video, comment below, subscribe to the channel, and of course, click that link to the next video in the series. The question of this video is, what aerodynamic design projects would you like to see, or have you done recently? So throw the answer to that in the comments below. When you're done doing that, click the link for the next video where we're going to discuss air fluids and whether air is a fluid. And I'll see you then.